Hello everyone and welcome back to RiceFix, and this is a 2018 model Alto. So to remove the front bumper, you'll have to open the hood first and take out these 5 bolts. So once you take out those 5 bolts, you'll have to use a pry tool and take out this plastic clip which is holding onto the bumper. As you can see, it is released here. Now put a tire under your bumper so that once you remove the bumper, you can rest the bumper on this tire. And then you go under the bumper and you have to remove more clips because there are clips which hold the bumper from underneath. So you'll have to use a screwdriver and take the clip out little bit, and then use a pry tool like this and take out the rest, and then pull the clip out like this. So there will be around 6 clips, but take out all of them in the similar manner. There will be a clip like this on the other side as well. My camera was not on, so I could not film it. But remove the one from the other side first, and then you come here and remove this one as well. So once you are done removing all the clips, come in the wheel wells, and as you can see, there is a screw here. To remove this screw, you'll have to turn the tire on the other side, and then you can easily remove this screw with a screwdriver. So once you remove that screw, you'll have to pull out the bumper, but you'll have to be very careful while pulling out the bumper. Don't break it while pulling. Just pull it down slightly and then pull it. It will come out nicely and easily. So as you can see how the clip locks are released, and I will show you a slightly closer look of the clip locks. As you can see, these are the clip locks which go inside the loops. So once you are done on one side, you come on the other side, turn the tire on the other side, remove the screw and take out the bumper from this side as well. So once you are done taking out the bumper from the other side, you remove your number plate, and under the number plate, as you can see, there is a bolt there. Just take that bolt out, and once you take out that bolt, and if your bumper is still not coming out, and if you just pull the bumper slightly and look inside, there is a clip lock inside which is holding the bumper. You'll have to release it. So pull the bumper slightly like this and take a long screwdriver and try to release that lock. So here my lock is released, and I will show you a slightly closer look on how the clip looks like. As you can see, this is the clip lock. This one go in this loop. So if your bumper is not coming out, just check that clip lock there. So this type of clip locks are on both the sides, so take out both of them. So once you release that lock, your bumper will come out nicely and easily like this. Now once the bumper is out, I will take out the grill on the bumper, and there are many screws like this which hold the grill to the bumper, so take out all of them. So once you take out those 6 screws, this grill is still not released yet because it is holding on to the clips, so you'll have to release all the clips which are holding it to the bumper. And here I'm done releasing all the clips, and now my bumper is ready for painting. So once I remove the grill, I will paint this bumper now. If you want to learn how to paint your own car bumper, then I have a separate channel on that. The link is in the description. You can go down there and check that channel out as well. So once I'm done painting, I will leave it for drying for around 24 hours, and then I will put a cloth under the bumper so that the bumper is not scratched, and I will put all the screws back, and I will clip the grill back onto the bumper. So once you are done clipping back the grill, as you can see here, my bumper is now ready to go back on the car. So I will put a tire under the bumper so that I can rest the bumper on that tire. On the hood if you had closed it, and then bring the bumper and rest it onto the tire. First put the clips which were there inside of the bumper, as you can see here. Once you are done putting them back, you have to put the clip locks on the sides back in position. And once you do that, just check for the mud guard. If it is gone inside by mistake, just take it out like this and put all the clips from underneath back in the slot. As you can see, the mud guard was slightly out here, so put it back in place and put back all the bolts which you had removed. Now turn the tire on one side and put the screws from both the sides, and as you can see here, my paint job is done and my fitting is also done, and the car is all set for delivery. All the scratches which were there on the bumper are gone completely.